Good evening, everyone. Hope you all are doing well. I, Ritika Parekh, along with my other group members, Pradipta Chatterjee, Samudra Ganguly, and Tushar Raj, am going to present on the topic COVID-19 detection from chest X-ray images using Python and deep learning. First of all, I would like to thank our project guide, SRC sir, for his immense support and guidance. And thank you so much to all the teachers for giving us the opportunity to present on this topic. Next slide, please. Basically, we have divided our entire presentation into four parts. First, we will be discussing about the project outline. Next, we'll be discussing about the importance of deep learning in this field. Then, in the implementation portion, we will be discussing about different models that we have used here. And finally, we will end our presentation by discussing about the next steps that we will be following to increase our model's accuracy. Next slide. Today, the amount of data that is generated by both humans and machines far outpaces humans' ability to absorb, interpret, and make complex decisions based on the data. So, artificial intelligence forms the basis for all the computer learning and is the future of all complex decision making. Thus, here we have used deep learning, which is a subset of machine learning, which in turn is a subset of artificial intelligence. Mainly, our main aim here is to detect COVID-19 using chest X-ray images. We have taken X-ray images of both COVID positive and normal persons as our raw input, and we have used deep learning CNN algorithm for classification of the X-ray images. Through the X-ray images, we can detect whether a person is COVID positive or COVID negative. All these images have been collected from different sources like Kaggle, GitHub, and Global COVID Chest X-ray dataset. First, we have done data pre-processing in Jupyter Notebook and then saved the data in the Google Drive. Next, we have uploaded the data to Google Colab for actually implementing the model. Next slide. So here we are using the Python programming language. So first of all, we have imported various libraries such as NumPy, which is the core library for scientific computing in Python, Matplotlib, which is an amazing visualization library in Python for 2D plots of array, Keras, which is an open source software library that provides the Python interface for artificial neural networks, and finally we have imported TensorFlow, which is a free and open source software library for machine learning and artificial intelligence in order to work with the images. We have also used GPU for better performance.
Good evening, sir. So I hope you all are doing great. Good evening, my teammates also. I'm Pradipta Chatterjee, and now this portion I will discuss the actual implementation of the CNN model. So the convolutional neural network, or basically any deep learning algorithm, there are basically two types of deep learning algorithm. One is RNN and another one is CNN. CNN is generally used in terms of processing or classifying any kinds of images. We have used this CNN algorithm, and especially the sequential model, and there are some layers also, internal layers that will be actually that will actually process the data. And I have used here two types of activation. Basically, one is ReLU and the another one is the sigmoid activation. And while training the model, I have used data generator function, and I have indexed the COVID positive images as COVID 0 and the normal images as 1. So this will be really very clear if I show you the actual Google Colab notebook, which is here. After uploading the data into our Google Drive, I have generally unzipped all the folder. The folder name was COVID-19, and I have mentioned here the train path and the validation path, that is the test path. After that, this here, we actually imported all the libraries like Matplotlib, Keras, and all the libraries. Keras is basically a high-end API for TensorFlow. TensorFlow has been used here. And here, this is the actual our model, CNN model, the sequential model. And the sequential model has some layers, and also the activation was ReLU for each of the steps. After actually implementing the model, we trained the model. And for training the model, we have used image data generator function. This function, with the help of this function, we trained the model and we have classified the model. After that, we can see here in the dictionary format, the Python dictionary format, all the images that have been indexed, that the value of the COVID positive was 0 and the value of the normal persons is 1. And then I have here used the epochs. I have used here a total 7 epochs. The total 7 epochs, although this was actually 8 epochs, but after that I had to change the value for implementing and increasing the accuracy. And at the last time it was 95% accurate. The accuracy was 95%. Still we are trying to increase the accuracy of this model. I have used 8 epochs and there are I have used 10 epochs here for increasing the accuracy. And there are total 8 steps per each epoch. So this was the basic implementation, and I am still trying to improve this accuracy. Actually, we all are trying to do this accuracy. So this was the basic training of our data set, and next portion will be discussed by our other team members.
Good evening, everyone. I am Shomutra Ganguly, and I am going to present from here. So the actual solution or the software which we are actually trying to create, the model which we are trying to create, is actually intended to take an X-ray image as input and predict whether the person or the person whose X-ray image has been given as input is COVID positive or not with certain degree of accuracy. And this will be implemented with the help of deep learning, as my teammates have already mentioned. So the actual goal of our solution is to provide a cost-efficient technique to find out whether a person has COVID or not, and also a quick solution. Can you please go to the next slide? The other solutions actually involve several tests and other long procedures which are also expensive. On the other hand, our solution actually provides a cost-efficient procedure and also quicker solution to find out whether a person has COVID or not, and it also gives with certain accuracy and probability that the person is actually COVID positive or not. So from here, my friend Tushar will continue.
Hello, good evening everyone. I am Tushar. I will discuss from here. Our next step will involve increasing the accuracy of our model, which is at present 87.2%, and deploying it on Android, iOS, and web platform, which makes it easy to use by everyone and anywhere. Next slide. Conclusion part. In this era of COVID-19, people are fighting the deadly virus for years. This project is helping. This project is to help people by providing a cost-effective and less time-taking alternative procedure to detect COVID-19 from X-ray image with the help of deep learning and available dataset. Our model has 87.2% accuracy at present. We are trying to improve it with the help of neural network and other algorithm. Next slide. We collected the references. We collected the data set and X-ray images from these hyperlinks for our project. Next slide. Thank you. On behalf of all group members, I thank you all for giving us such an opportunity. Thank you all.
what are the data? Can I show the data set? What are the attributes the data set have actually?
Yes, sir.
Can I show the data set?
Yes, sir, exactly.
The attributes of the data set actually, I want to
know. Okay, sir, just wait a minute. Sir, I'm just presenting. Just wait a minute.
Mm-hmm. Take your time.
This was the data set, and it was pre-processed in the Jupyter notebook, and the COVID, these are images, that's why we use GPU, because these are all chest images, and these are all the COVID positive images in the COVID folder, and the normal images were in normal folder, all the chest X-ray images, and then it is uploaded into Google Drive and my Dropbox folder also. Then from there I imported.
It's is there any ratio regarding the training set and
what is
it? Is there any ratio that this much amount of data you have used for training set and this much?
Sir, 50-50. I have total almost 196 images almost at that time, and whenever I am getting more images, I am adding it, and 196 COVID positive and 196 COVID negative. And again, if there is some issue with some images, then I am reducing it to 142. I have, and always we are trying to improve the accuracy. So on an average, the accuracy is 87.5% plus minus 5%. Right now it is showing 95% when I rerun the program, just some time before. So, and it may also show 85% also sometime, because it is now also in training. It took almost 1 week because of system requirement.
So where do you got GPU?
So in Google Colab. In Google Colab, let me show you.
Okay. How much time actually you are requires?
This is the runtime, and the runtime was. So it is now not running actually, because I have to again connect it.
No, it's okay.
So if I connect it, then it will, the runtime will show CPU or GPU option, because we are actually dealing with images, and those are large images. The actual data was almost a 5 to 6 GB, the total data set was. That's why I have used GPU.
And the person who is actually used the data, the actual work where the data is being used, have you compared with their accuracy and your accuracy? Do you have any information like that?
Do I have any I'm not able to get it, sir.
This data is being used by in some project, right? So they have got some accuracy applying their
sir no in not this actual data. Each day the data are been updated, so okay. Each day, so that's why whenever we are running this, and again the data is updated, so this is how we are trying to actually improve the accuracy.
My issue is the actual project where this data